I was like, okay, there is no flip out screen, so let's just get a monitor, no problem in that. I built myself a custom mount for the Ronin S and stuff like that, just to find out that you will lose a face detection feature. Now, why is that? You can still use a face detection if you use an external recorder. You will, you know, you get to keep this feature, but you will lose another sweet feature. You will lose the
initiating.
Welcome back. My daily grind, create yourself, is what you'll find me doing every day and every night. No time to lose, one day, one step in the right direction. I'm Chris and I'm only here to show you if I can do it, you can do it too.
Welcome back to the vlog. It is Wednesday, another day, another chance to push hard. And the topic for this vlog is a public service announcement. Do not use a monitor with the Sony a7 III, so let's get it. By the way, all the equipment vlogs right here, watch them all. But before we get started, love goes out to all my subscribers. Thank you for making my life special and worth living to the max. So let me try to be back with a sweet, sweet video. Oh my god, I just filmed two vlogs and my freaking hand. My shoulder is giving up. Stop screaming, you will adapt to this. So in my last vlog, I demonstrated the face detection on versus face detection off feature and the importance of this feature, especially when it gets to vlogging. So if you missed this vlog, check it out. And to demonstrate this feature, I just connected and disconnected the monitor. So do not use a monitor with your Sony a7 III if it's for, you know, seeing yourself purposes. That's a stupid idea. You might use it for, you know, when you film someone else or something like that to get a bigger picture. But if it's for vlogging, do not get yourself a monitor. If you're looking into upgrading your gear, like me, if you're interested in all my gear, check out this vlog. I was like, okay, there is no flip out screen, so let's just get a monitor, no problem in that. I built myself a custom mount for the Ronin S and stuff like that. Wasted a few hours of my life just to find out that you will lose a face detection feature. Now, why is that? It is 2018, but it's also not 2020. So even though this camera is super advanced, it's not there yet. It still only has a limited processing power on board. And if you connect a monitor, then it will basically act like a graphics card and display the video feed to the monitor. So there are basically not enough resources to feed an external monitor and the face detection feature. And that was a massive bummer, because not only did I waste time, I also wasted money and my own resources, basically my own processing power. What am I talking? So be aware of that. There might be other things that will happen when you connect a monitor, but the most important one is definitely this face detection feature, because it is just so amazing and it's basically all you ever want for vlogging. So stay away from these goddamn monitors. Also, another good thing to know is if you're thinking about getting yourself an external recorder, because this will solve this issue, you can still use the face detection if you use the HDMI output and use an external recorder. You will, you know, you get to keep this feature, but you will lose another sweet feature. You will lose the 120 FPS slow motion, because HDMI only supports a 60 FPS output, like a 60 FPS stream. 60 FPS is the max frame rate that you will get with an external recorder on a Sony a7 III. So that's another I thought about getting myself a recorder, but thankfully this time I got aware of this issue before I actually bought it. The monitor was like, I paid 160 bucks for this one. This is the FeelWorld F6, and I almost went for the Atomos Ninja 5, which is like 500-600 bucks, something like that. So thankfully I did not fall in this trap. And if you're wondering how am I able to see myself, then check out this vlog. I built myself a tilted mirror contraption thingy for the hot shoe, actually, and it works pretty good. You know, I can see myself up there. It's not as nice as a big nice monitor, but it's all I need. It gets the job done and it's a bit lighter. My setup at this very moment, it clocks in at 3.6, something like that. It's still super heavy, but with the monitor it was 4 kilograms, so I appreciate it. But yeah, that's it for this vlog. That's enough progress for today. Smash that like button, the way I want to smash myself just a bit for not figuring out all of that earlier. But anyways, bang the bell like to never miss equipment vlogs. Check the recent news on chrisviral.com. And yeah, that's it for today. I will see you tomorrow.